Welcome back to school, everyone. I know you guys have received your Safe Schools modules. I'm going to start off my presentation here with why I didn't assign Safe Schools COVID-19 modules. First of all, I'm not saying don't watch them. There's useful information in them. However, let me give you a couple of examples of why I did not assign them. First, the cleaning module spent a bit of time on how to use bleach. I did not want to leave you with the impression that bleach was how we deal with COVID-19. I did not want to make this module mandatory because the most recent guidance I have received from the Washington State Department of Health had a link to a University of Washington handout with options for safer cleaning and disinfecting products that work well against COVID-19. That handout specifically states, avoid sodium hypochlorite, bleach, if possible. I have uploaded the safe cleaning handout to my Google Classroom, but I will defer any additional questions on that topic to our facilities maintenance experts. Moving on, the mask module shows you how to make your own masks, which is cool, but I did not want to make it mandatory because the tutorial demonstrates how to sew a 2-layer mask. The World Health Organization recommends a 3-layer mask. One more example. The coronavirus overview did not have the latest symptom list. For example, there was no mention of loss of taste or smell, nor was this module updated on risk factors such as poverty or pregnancy. It did not mention that obesity in the younger population was a significant risk factor for severe complications. So here's my presentation on COVID-19, and not because I can do a better job than the Safe Schools modules. It is just a matter of staying up to date as we self-correct and modify our responses to this disease. That being said, I would like to apologize in advance if what I present to you today is outdated by this afternoon after my Zoom with the local health department. Fall 2020-2021 guidance. From the Washington State Department of Health, updated August 4th, 2020, from the previous guidance released on August 3rd, 2020. Schools are fundamental to child and adolescent development. Okay. Stop right there. I am not going to read this at healthcare tutorial speed because I do not want my audience to fall asleep or throw tomatoes at me. My presentation is based on this most recent guidance. I will post it to my virtual school nurse office. For my presentation, I am mainly going to highlight the key principles, the mainstays of this guidance, which are these. Number one, keep ill persons out of school, educating students, families, and staff to stay home when sick, and using screening. First, educating students, families, and staff. I have struggled all summer with how to communicate health information to students, families, and staff. So I now have a virtual school nurse office, and I will post new material to it regularly. I was also in communication with Deb Stenberg, our communications ambassador, and she helped me get material onto the district website, including a link for staff to my Google Classroom. I have an office for staff and an office for students. I will invite every student, and maybe 15% will join. I base that number off of how many staff members have accepted my invitation. I am not a teacher, so I cannot assign material to students. I can only try to catch their attention. So I really need teachers to promote health topics this year. I know at least one of you has a quote of the day for students. My plea is that during this pandemic, please consider a health topic a day, or at least a week, that you will share with your students. You can use what I post or what you have already found is most appropriate for your students, but I need your help with this. If any of our students or their families need materials in another language, let me know so I can try to accommodate them. And then there's screening. There is conflicting guidance as to whether or not to screen in the first place. As per the CDC website, which states, Based on the best available evidence at this time, CDC does not currently recommend universal symptom screening all students grades K through 12, be conducted by schools. But the guidance Washington schools are following is from the Washington Department of Health, which does recommend screening. This has been a big fail for us right off the bat, because I was relying on either Skyward or Qualtrics apps to facilitate our screening measures. But neither of those apps are 100% functional yet, and I don't know when they will be. That has left our secretary scrambling to make our own screening system. So starting out with Coach Crowther's gym check-in as our base model, I know Jody has volunteered to get that operational, so to speak, but we did have to add some things. Basically, it will look something like this. In the past 24 hours, have you experienced any of these symptoms in a way not normal to you? If this is your first day after a break or for a new student, have you experienced any of these symptoms in a way not normal to you in the past 3 days or 72 hours? Fever or chills. Fever is defined as a temperature of greater than 100.4. Cough, sore throat, shortness of breath, congestion or runny nose, new loss of taste or smell, diarrhea, fatigue, headache, muscle or body aches, nausea or vomiting. Have you been in close contact with anyone with confirmed COVID-19? Have you had a positive COVID-19 test for active virus in the past 10 days? Within the past 14 days, has a public health or medical professional told you to self-monitor, self-isolate, or self-quarantine because of concerns about COVID-19 infection? Number two, cohorts. Conducting all activities in small groups that remain together over time with minimal mixing of groups. This really shakes up the way things have always been done in public education, but it suggests that a group of students will stay in one place and it is the teachers who will rotate. However, I don't see Mr. Traer being able to pack up his chemistry set and travel door to door with his experiments, or Chef Sean to drive from room to room in a food truck. Unless...
Icatus figatus somber kazee! I want your attention, everything! We're packing to leave. Come on, let's go. No, no, not you. Books are always first, you know. Pockety, pockety, wackety, whack. Abra, 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 knack. Shrinking size, very small. We got to save enough room for all. Higgitus, figgitus, figgitus, mum. Crescidage and pony, hunky! Malika says, Malika mesmeripides. Pockety, 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 whoa! Now stop, 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 stop. See here, sugar boy, you're getting rough. That poor old tea set is cracked enough. All right, let's start again. Where was I, boy?
Hockety, pockety?
Oh, yes, that's right. Pockety, pockety, wackety, whack. Odds and ends and brick and brush. Be with you in just a minute. Packing's almost done.
You bungling blockhead.
Hey, that's easy there. No, go ahead. Dum, goodly, doodly, doodly, dum. This is the best part now. Higgitus, figgitus, figgitus, boom. Prestidigitonium. Higgitus, figgitus, figgitus, boom. Prestidigitonium.
Wherever possible, though, cohort. This will help to minimize the mixing of students in the hallways like we saw in Georgia. It is also recommended to have assigned seating, as that will help health department officials and school staff who have to do the contact tracing to more quickly identify close contacts of COVID-19 cases when they occur so that those individuals can be quarantined. Initial guidance was that schools shall not do the contact tracing. Now it is that schools shall do the contact tracing. I imagine that will go something like this.
Well, guys, one of the big things everyone's talking about right now is reopening of schools. And I heard that contact tracing will be a big part of reducing COVID in classrooms. Here to comment is Eastridge County 8th grader Riley Spellman. Hi, Riley. Thank you for being here. So you're starting up school in the fall. Do you think contact tracing will actually work?
Oh, for sure, Jimmy. I'm not worried.
Okay, I got it. Well, I thought it'd be fun if we just practice maybe a little right now. So, Riley, other than your family, can you tell us who you've been in contact with in the last week?
No one, just my family.
Really? That's great. I guess that shows how easy...
And Ashley M.
Ashley M, okay.
But she doesn't count. She's my BFF, so she's basically like family.
Well, no, actually, she's not family, but that's fine. So all we have to do for contact tracing is call Ashley M, and we'd be good.
Although I saw on Ashley M's Finsta that she got froyo with Brian L.
She got froyo. Okay, well, okay.
And I know he saw MR, not the one from our school, the one from Southbrook Middle, because they did a TikTok together. And TBH, it was cringe. Plus, Emma went to the park with Cooper. I mean, they wore masks, obvs. But Cooper does this really funny thing where he puts his mask over his chest like a bra. So I think that counts as contact.
That definitely does count. Is that it right there?
Yes, but actually no, because Cooper and Kylie for sure hung out, because high key, she told me she wants to get with him before school starts. Problem is, Kylie is still dating Dustin, whose brother licks poles.
What?
And so Dustin is joking that Kylie wants to HU Cooper. Anyway, I'm sure none of this matters. But sorry for the tea overload, but like... Yeah.
Actually, all of this matters, Riley, because this is what contact tracing is.
Oh. Well, yeah, this will never work.
Riley Spellman, everyone, put your hands together.
I don't know.
And it still counts as...
Number 3, physical distancing, minimizing close contact with other people, which at the moment is a distance of 6 feet. How many of you have heard you need to wash your hands? How many of you have heard you need to wear a mask? How many of you have heard you need to social distance?
These look like pool noodles taped to a bike helmet, but it does the job, I guess.
Damn trees. Stay 6 feet away from me, trees. Stop it. Stop touching my noodle. Oh, we're... Hey, 6 feet, pole. 6 feet, 6 feet. 6 feet, 6 feet. 6 feet. Hey, 6 feet. 6 feet. Moron. 6 feet. 6 feet. 6 feet.
All of you? Because if one of you answers you haven't heard that, then I'm going to ask you... Where in the entire world have you been?
Did you watch the news today? Did you hear what they say? 1,000 more people passed away. Oh no. Somebody tell me what's going on. New York, New York, big city of dreams. There's a nightmare going down from the Bronx to Queens and everywhere in between. We fighting something we can't even see. There's an invisible enemy. Just knocked out Italy. Keep the mask on, cause if you cough, they gon' look at you like you did a felony. And they say we can't hug nobody, not until we find a remedy. So we pray for Spain, France and the UK, China and USA. I pray we gon' be okay. Pray for the grandmas and grandpas, so they can live to see another day. Did you watch the news today? Did you hear what they say?
They say they're worried, folks, it's all a hoax. The news is fake and it's all a joke. The death toll's rising with broken hopes. Now they got a cure and an antidote. Inject yourself with the bleach and soap. And a check's in the mail cause they know we're broke.
Did you watch the news today? Did you hear what they said?
They said no one's allowed to see the Pope. It's a ghost town, coast to coast. We're just people that's trying to cope. From different sides with different strokes.
Living different lives from different tribes. But everybody's in the same boat. Did you hear the news today? They say the world is one. Cause we're all fighting the war. But nobody pick up a gun. We got nurses and doctors. They fighting in the front line. Saving lives. I'm waiting in line. I'm frightened. In the store. Ah, that's the hero. Behind the counter. They making the world go round. Risking new encounters. They in the front line. Dying for the minimum wage. Did you watch the news today? Did you hear what they say?
They say stay in the house, don't step out. If you step out, put the mask on the mouth. 6 feet back, virus attack. Soap on the hands so your lungs don't collapse. Don't know the truth, don't know the facts. Robo killing all the brown and the black.
COVID-19 got us on the knees. Got the temperature rising 106 degrees. They don't care if you speak Cantonese, Francois or Portuguese, Espanol or Japanese. Got us all saying, I can't breathe. Ah, isn't it ironic? When we can't breathe, the planet breathes. And we can see blue sky, blue seas, green leaves, birds and bees. I don't know what to believe. All the lies or conspiracies. Ah, did you hear the news today? Did you hear what they say? 1,000 more people passed away. Oh, nah. Somebody tell me what's going on and on and on and on and on.
What can we do? We don't have tape on the floor telling us where to stand. But let me ask you, if I walk by you and I see that you are not standing on your piece of tape, what am I supposed to do about that? Do I give you first the verbal warning? Second, the written warning. Third, the letter of termination. Or do I simply call on someone to physically escort you from the building? You are union, and I know I am not going to be able to get away with any draconian protocol de hospital. The latest guidance tells us to think creatively about all opportunities to increase physical space between students. But might I suggest we go back to Aristotle, who said, persuasion is clearly a sort of demonstration, since we are most fully persuaded when we consider a thing to have been demonstrated.
Bye.
We have proprioception. We know our movements in space and our body position. It's how we defy gravity every day. If we can defy gravity every day without even thinking about it, I'm pretty sure we can also maintain social distancing and demonstrate that for our students. But I will defer to the admin and the union as to whether or not you want tape or signage. Number 4, hand hygiene. Frequent washing with soap and water or using alcohol-based hand gel. This is not new information, nor is it any more urgent now than it has ever been. I'm not going to give you the worldwide statistics of how many people die every year from hospital-acquired infections, but next time you go to the doctor or the hospital, pay attention to who performs hand hygiene and who does not. If they don't, tell them to. It's a basic patient right. Education is key here. I want everyone washing their hands. I want everyone doing it the right way.
That is the stupidest thing I've ever seen.
That was my son. He reminded me of when I was showing a young man at Ocean Shores Elementary how to wash his hands, and I got that look. I already know how to wash my hands, which is never. Maybe I'm not doing it right, but this guy is definitely onto something.
We need good hygiene to keep living. Lather up for 20 whole seconds and you kill it. Come in time to the germs, don't keep winning. We need good hygiene.
Hygiene.
Mama said to me every day, wash your hands and don't touch your face. Hand sanitizer, soap and hot water after everything. When you do anything.
So you're a tough guy, like to touch the mug guy, like to keep your palms dry, cough into your hands guy. I'm the clean type, like to see it clean type, trust the CDC type, scrub the surface sheen type. I'm the bath guy.
Duh.
Now watch it drip.
Kill it.
Now you wait.
20 seconds.
Now watch it drip.
You soap.
Now you
sneeze, bro. Shouldn't use your hands better in that sleeve, though. If you got a cough, catch it in your elbow. No shaking hands, we can wave for hello. Don't go out, bro. We don't want to spread any more disease, so we should follow everything the CDC knows. You'll be feeling better in a couple weeks, though.
I mean, I hope so. I have a hands, I have a soul. Soapy hands.
You just got home late and got cooking on your brain. You can save the day, mm-hmm, if you wash the germs away, mm-hmm. Cause the water's gonna spray for 20
won't stop the spread of COVID-19. Yeah, yeah.
This song just like gold, that hot water based combo. This thing for the mad germs, them sad germs, that bad disease. Soap hits you, hallelujah. Cause unclean funk gon' give it to you. Cause unclean funk gon' give it to you.
Wash up, gonna make myself some mash. Now you know I'm sink bound. 20 second count, that's round. Hot water, soap, rinse, lather, and repeat. Now,
can nobody stop this scrubbing? You can't stop this scrubbing.
Yeah, I'm gonna take my hands to a one sink flow. I'm gonna wash till my fingers glow. I'm gonna take my hands to a warm sink bowl. I'm gonna wash so these will end. Wash your hands, do 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 do. Wash your hands, do 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 do. Wash your hands, do 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 do. Wash your hands.
No, but seriously.
Hey everyone, I hope this finds you doing amazing. Guys, this is all about protecting people who cannot protect themselves. So wash your hands.
And stay home.
We can do this.
Together.
If you have any more information about how to keep yourself healthy or protect those around you, check out the description below.
And share this song.
Sing it while you wash your hands, too. That's
right. And all the revenue for this song is going to the global relief effort for this virus. Let's kick its butt. We can do this.
Thanks, guys.
Thanks.
Wash your hands and get your kids to wash their hands. I'll take this opportunity to ask the principals if I can reward kids with the incentives you give for good behavior. Because if any kid can show me how to wash their hands the right way, they deserve a prize.
Tops and bottoms, tops and bottoms, in between, scrub them all together, scrub them all together, till they're clean.
Personal protective equipment, use of face coverings or shields and barriers, PPE, it's all the rage now. And I mean rage and raging sorrow. Some of us will have to gown up and wear PPE. A cloth face mask is not really considered PPE. A disposable mask is considered PPE. Our staff will at times be put into medium risk categories and they will need PPE. Problem is there is a shortage of it, and that PPE needs to be reserved for frontline healthcare workers, which is why supplies I ordered last spring are still on back order. There was also supposed to be some magical windfall of some bulk group order for the schools, which I have not seen materialized. Maybe the supplies got shunted to schools that were opening. If I have learned anything this summer, it is that it hasn't done me any good to wait for guidance or wait for supplies. My Aaron Burr philosophy of wait for it has failed. At times, I have felt like we are alone in this community, that each other is all that we have. But you know, the each other that we do have, that's a very good thing. So let's keep each other safe. The school has a responsibility to keep you safe, but you are all adults. What are you doing to keep yourself safe? Because this is going to be a team effort. We are all the school. Number 6, environmental cleaning and disinfection, especially of high-touch surfaces. So I spoke of this earlier, and again, I defer to Stan and his crew on this one. But one more thing I will say here is, it is not just custodial staff's job to keep our work areas clean. It is a job for all of us. Number 7, improve indoor ventilation. But enough of this. It's story time. Said Osmond to his ward, the little Duke Richard, after the assassination of Richard's father and their confinement in Frankish territory. No wonder these poor creatures of French cannot stand before a Norman lance. If they cannot sleep without glass to their windows, well, what would my father say to this? My grandmother will never believe what I had to tell her. Glass windows and hangings to sleeping chambers. I do not like it. I am sure we shall never be able to sleep closed up from the free air of heaven in this way. Besides, my father would blame me for letting you be made tender as a crank. I'll have out this precious window if I can. Osmond did not find much difficulty in displacing the windows and letting in the sharp, cold, wintry breeze. Fast forward, Osmond helped Richard escape. Richard grew up to become Richard the Fearless. Sound old-fashioned to you? Well, it is. So is Florence Nightingale, the founder of modern nursing. She is fondly remembered as the Lady with a Lamp. Soldiers were cannon fodder left to rot in unsanitary barracks. She fought for sanitation reforms. Most people think that only refers to clean water or sewage, but to her, a key component of it was stale air versus fresh air. Her reforms saved soldiers' lives. Today, hospitals spend millions of dollars on negative pressure isolation rooms, and in a lot of hospitals, you can't even open a window. Even though I remember reading a study about 12 years ago that opening windows was just as effective and more in some situations. Fresh air is vitality. Fortunately, we have buildings where you can actually open the windows. So this is not a joke. This is real. Open your windows in your classrooms. Wear layers if you have to so you stay warm. Number 8, isolation of sick people and exclude exposed people. Medication will have to be given in a different area than is designated as the isolation area. This will become an issue when the kids come back into the building. This is where we are going to have some medium risk exposure. Staff who care for a sick child while parents are on the way to come pick them up will have to gown up in PPE. If that child tests positive for COVID-19, contact tracing will be done. The staff member who cared for the child, or children, plural, I bet, will be questioned by the health department to determine their risk of exposure. If that staff member was wearing PPE, that staff member will not be quarantined. If that staff member was not wearing PPE, that staff member would be quarantined. Isolation is going to be a challenge for our schools, especially at PBE where there is not a dedicated health room. I know that some schools have adopted using the gyms as the isolation area, especially when indoor sports are out of the question right now. The guidance states, quote, "A room with several cots spaced at least 6 feet apart with privacy curtains between cots could be used. Ideally, the isolation unit would have a private bathroom for use only by persons being evaluated for COVID." Well, we are a school, not a hospital. So if we have more than a couple sick kids, the students will have to sit on a chair at least 6 feet apart in the gym. If they are so sick they cannot sit on a chair, then we need to call 911. Number 9, with the previous considerations foremost, outdoor activities are safer than indoor activities.
Okay, true or false? Sunlight kills the virus.
It does. That's a truism. That's one of the reasons why outside, in the sun, when you are interacting, that is much, much better than being inside.
Again, stay out of the recirculated air. It's better to be outside and in the open air, sunlight, better than more recirculated air inside.
Exactly. And that's the reason why one of the 4 or 5 things that we say are important is outside is always better than inside. Okay. And that's why when restaurants open, if they open, you encourage tables that are outside and separated from each other.
Is this why you think that so many of the island countries have such low numbers? Because they have more of an outdoor lifestyle?
It's quite conceivable that that's the case. Absolutely. Yeah.
Okay.
And those are the 9 key principles of the guidance. I hear you thinking, because I might be thinking the same thing, but we've already heard all that before. Where's the nitty gritty? Without a foundation, there is no place to pin the nitty gritty specific practical details, and they're basically rendered pointless. What I shared with you are the 9 key principles of the guidance. They are the pillar, backbone, bulwark, main support, the mainstays of the guidance. And if I come into the building and see people hiding from me and hurriedly putting on their masks like I am the mask police and separating themselves like I am the soap drop in a water surface tension experiment, well, all I can say is Ship North Beach, without its mainstay, loses its ability to keep the virus pirates from boarding the ship. As you know, Aberdeen schools are opening, and it is my understanding we are adopting their nitty-gritty for opening schools, which is basically the 9 key principles. We will learn from Aberdeen's failures, and we will learn from their successes. The guidance will probably be updated. And on that note, I just want to leave you with this.
This is either madness or brilliance.
It's remarkable how often those two traits coincide.
By 2 men. You'll never make it out of the bay.
Son, I'm Captain Jack Sparrow. Savvy?
Commodore!
Rash, Turner. Too rash. That is without doubt the worst pirate I have ever seen.
Here they come.
Bring her around! Bring her around!
Search every cabin, every hole, down to the bilges.
We won't catch them.
I don't need to catch them. Just get them in range of the long nines.
Out! Come about! Run out the guns!
We ought to find our own ships, huh?
I'd rather see her at the bottom of the ocean than in the hands of a pirate.
Commodore! He's disabled the rudder chain, sir.
Abandon ship!
That's got to be the best pirate I've ever seen.
So it would seem.